Do you think you're ready to engage people once again after 2 years or three and a half, 2.5 years of no activity brought about by COVID-19?
I think the advantage of the lockdown and the past 2 years has been like most of the creatives, whether they are independent or not, have been engaged in a process of creating content. Mm-hmm. And I'm curious to see what's going to come out of this now that we are free to start working. I'm sure everyone is going to be ready to prepare to present something that they've been working on. Mm-hmm. So I'm not really worried about if there is content. I think I'm very worried about who is going to present it, because most people have have really moved on.
Yes.
I mean, they realized that they were chasing a dead horse, you know, and they were like, you know, we are not going to survive 2 years of not working, even trying to mitigate the, you know, life. Now that they are, you know, they have started some jobs, you know, if you have a job that is 9 to 5, you're not going to start, you know, going for rehearsals or going to dance in a studio. And what are you going to eat if you go there? So I think my biggest worry is about who is going to be presenting the content, mm-hmm. whether it's dance, whether it's theater, whether it's music, whether it's film. Okay, film is different. But I think there are certain art forms that are independent and they really need an effort for someone to be able to present it. And I think opening up without any support structure to help these people get back into the market, it's going to be really, really difficult. So for me, I think that's going to be the biggest challenge.
Okay. So when you say there are certain art form that needs really, really support, and there's some that needs to, what are those, you know, can you highlight some of them that needs to?
Yes. I mean, when we are talking about like the independent art scene, we are talking about some of the independent artists I know, mm-hmm. and they are the most challenged one are the contemporary dancers. Mm-hmm. The contemporary dancers, first of all, contemporary dance is very, very new to the industry, to the market here. And even when they have been working over the years, you know, dancers like, you know, Jonas, like Julius, like Oscar, have been really working hard to really cultivate their audiences. And they have been not really managing to get them, you know, to get them to fill up the auditoriums. And now that they are back, they need a lot of time. They need at least 6 to 8 months to prepare a production, and which means that now that they don't have money and they are opened up to start, they needed someone to, you know, or they needed some kind of like a support fund to get them to start so that they can be able to prepare their work to present it to the audiences.
Okay.
Yeah.
And what kind of support are we looking at here?
Money, of course. I mean, it's money. I don't think, you know, there's anything else, maybe also space. Mm-hmm. Space is also an important thing because some of them need space. They might have time and they might have money to survive on where to stay, but they definitely need space to rehearse on. So.